I would never get out of bed for $300, and you shouldn't either. Let's talk about how much you can and should be charging for your videography services. At this point, I don't get out of bed for anything less than $1,000. And if you're wondering how you can get there, then hit the like and subscribe button below so we can send more videos your way that will help you crush it this year in videography and in live streaming. The price of a video isn't just derived from the end result. You can't look at a video and know what went into it. Was there a 2-hour travel to the client? Did you fly across the country? Did you shoot for half a day? A full day? A week? Did you bring out things like a teleprompter, additional cameras, additional camera operators, or production assistants to be an extra hand? None of that stuff can be determined from just watching an end product video. With that in mind, there are two schools of thought: charging based on time you put into a project and charging for value that you bring to the table. There's no right or wrong because everyone is different and has their unique way of doing things. I bill for a hybrid of the two, and keep in mind these prices are exact prices I'm billing right now, and they're accounting for my 4-year college degree and 11 years in doing this professionally. So if I have a half-day video shoot, I'm billing $125 per hour from arrival to departure per videographer, with a minimum of 3 hours if it's a shorter local shoot, and in some cases, I just give them a flat $500 for the half day. Then, if I'm bringing out equipment, I'll charge accordingly. This might be $100 for a second camera, $50 for a slider, $150 for a teleprompter, $200 for an interview lighting kit, $100 for a sit-down interview audio setup. But I'm not showing the client the full breakdown. Otherwise, this sets me up for them to nitpick every little detail, thinking this is an a la carte scenario. This isn't Starbucks where you can add an extra shot of espresso for just another buck. I'm just saying it's $600 for equipment. That puts us at $500 for the labor, $600 for the gear, and we haven't started talking about editing yet. This is where I get my I won't get out of bed price of $1,000. Then on the editing side, I bill $100 an hour for editing, and this is where my 11 years of doing this professionally come in. I'm estimating that a project will take X amount of hours. So maybe a 2 to 3 minute video would be 15 hours of editing time. Then I include a couple hours for revisions. I make it clear to the client that we go through 2 revision rounds, and that's included up to 2 hours a piece. And then beyond that, it's additional build time at $100 per hour. So that's another $1,500 for the edit, plus $400 for the revisions. So for me, this would be $500 plus $600 plus $1,900 for a total of $3,000 from start to finish. Regardless, if you're just getting into this and you're not sure what to charge and this client only paid you $300, it's highway robbery, and you could easily be making 3 to 4 times that for your videos. The trick is learning how to show the client the value in what you bring to the table. So when you drop a price like that, there's no question that it will be worthwhile. Even better, when you drop a price that's 20x, there's still no hesitation because the client knows that they're going to get exactly what they want. This is where it will be important to study marketing, sales, and to truly learn how you can help a client get a result after their video is done. Likes don't equate to dollars. Fill in that gap and you'll have yourself a client for life. So what questions do you have around pricing for video production work? Let's chat more in the comments. Feel free to leave me your questions below, or if you are a fellow videographer, let's help out our colleagues and share how you price out your projects in a comment. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, and I'll see you down under, in the comment section, that is.